BMWs have a variable valve timing system with a fancy name called VANOS. On engines with dual VANOS and dual VANOS with valvetronic, the VANOS solenoids, which is this thing right here, fail very frequently, which leads to a number of performance-related and driving issues. I went ahead and did a video a while back covering the BMW VANOS system in general, explaining the different types of VANOS systems, as well as the engines that they're used on, and talked a little bit about how they function and how they work. This video, we're specifically going to talk about VANOS solenoids, why they fail, the signs and symptoms of them failing, and what your replacement options are when one of these does go bad. So first of all, these VANOS solenoids are predominantly used on the engines with dual VANOS and dual VANOS with valvetronic, which is going to be your N52, your N54, N55, N62, M52, M54, S54, and pretty much every engine that's been newer than the N54 and the N55 since then. And so there's a whole lot of engines that use these nowadays, and as I mentioned, they fail frequently. First off, let's go ahead and talk just briefly about how VANOS works and what the whole purpose of these solenoids is. VANOS is variable valve timing. Dual VANOS just means that we have variable valve timing for both the intake camshaft and the exhaust camshaft. We have two of these solenoids that are used on all of these vehicles. One controls the intake camshaft and one controls the exhaust camshaft. The way that VANOS works is you have an actuator that has a gear on it, and then you have a gear on the intake and the exhaust camshaft, and you have an actuator that presses that gear outwards and inwards to interact with the camshaft to ultimately control valve timing. The way that that camshaft gear and the actuator works is via these VANOS solenoids. So it is an oil pressure activated system, meaning to get the cam gear to start sliding outwards to interact with the camshaft, it uses oil pressure. The main thing that controls oil pressure is the solenoid right here. If you look and see, there's a bunch of little holes through here. And what happens is these holes have oil flowing through them, and that oil ends up getting sent through the top of this to that gear to cause the gear to slide in and out. So what happens over time is all of these little holes in the inside of here get gunked up over time just from the amount of oil that passes through it. It's very easy for them to collect any dirt or debris that might be in your oil and effectively reduce the amount of oil flow that's going through them and being sent to that cam gear. When these things do get gunked up, what happens is it weakens the amount of oil flow that's going to it and effectively disables your variable valve timing system. And that leads to a number of performance related issues when that happens. So when these things get gunked up and start to go bad, you're going to notice a number of symptoms such as loss of power and torque. Your engine will frequently go into limp mode when you try accelerating. You'll have decreased throttle response. You'll have a rough idle, and you'll also have slow cold starts as well. Now, these things do tend to get gunked up and fail a little bit more slowly over time, and so you won't necessarily notice all of these symptoms immediately. Sometimes you might think that you've got bad spark plugs or bad ignition coils because you're getting some misfires and rough idling, but over time the symptoms will get more and more severe, which is going to be something that can lead you to the problem being with the VANOS solenoids rather than with the spark plugs. So in terms of diagnosing whether it is the VANOS solenoids that are bad, your best bet's first going to be reading the engine codes. If the VANOS solenoids are bad, you're going to see a 2A82 or a 2A87 code. Those are the ones that are a guarantee that you're having an issue with this VANOS solenoid and that you need to replace it. But you might also get a number of P engine codes that could indicate a problem with a VANOS solenoid or with a camshaft position sensor as well. So those codes for the dual VANOS engines, which is the N52, N54, N55, N62, and then the N73 and N74, is going to be a P1520, a P1523, or a P1397. And if you have a dual VANOS with valvetronic, which is any of the newer engines, you're going to get P0011 through P0025. Again, if you are getting the 2A82 and 2A87, then that's a telltale sign that you need to replace these If you're getting any of those P-related codes, that could be because you have a bad camshaft position sensor. So you're gonna wanna go ahead and read your codes and be on the lookout for which of these ones that you're showing. Now, a lot of the times, a bad crankshaft position sensor could cause a lot more starting-related issues and poor running. You'll start to notice more subtle symptoms when the VANOS solenoid goes bad, whereas when a camshaft position sensor goes bad, those symptoms show up right when the sensor goes bad, versus deteriorating more so over time, like what's gonna happen with the VANOS solenoid. So now when it comes to replacing these things, the genuine BMW VANOS solenoids are $300 each, and you have two of them, and so they're extremely expensive to replace. A lot of people will pull them out and just try giving them a good thorough cleaning and seeing if you can release some of the gunk that's built up in here and restricting the oil flow. While cleaning them is an effective tactic, you might get an extra couple thousand miles or an extra 10,000 miles out of them, but it's really just a band-aid and doesn't fully fix the problem. You'll need to go ahead and replace the whole VANOS solenoid, otherwise this issue is gonna pop up at another time. The genuine BMW ones are like $600 and they fail a lot, so we never recommend buying the genuine ones just because they're so expensive, they're known to be a common problem. Why buy them when you know they're gonna fail again at some point? If you wanna look at aftermarket options, your best option on the market's gonna be Pierre Berg. Pierre Berg, honestly, I would say is even better quality than the genuine BMW ones. They're gonna be the most reliable, but they also do come at a little bit of a premium. They're definitely cheaper than the BMW ones that are $300, but they still are relatively expensive, but those are gonna be the best option on the market. If you've got a high mileage car or you're just looking for a more budget or value fix, you can get the URO or the Phoebe Bilstein VANOS solenoids, which are probably about half the cost as the Pierre Berg ones. You will have to replace them a little bit more often than you would with Pierre Berg, but they are half the cost. And so if you're DIYing it and you don't mind changing them out again, it might not be a bad idea to go ahead and save a little bit of money and get a value brand as well. But anyways, guys, that covers pretty much everything we have on VANOS solenoids here. These things are crucial for your variable valve timing to work properly, and you need variable valve timing to work for your engine to run properly and to be drivable. As you start to run into issues with these, you will notice the performance issues continuing to get worse and worse, and you will need to go ahead and replace these. You can go ahead and give these things a cleaning to get a little bit of extra life out of them, but you will eventually need to replace them. And these things do fail frequently, especially on N54, N55, and N62 vehicles. The newer vehicles, these seem to be a little bit better on, but just know that these are a very common failure item and will need to be replaced eventually. Well, that's everything we've got on BMW VANOS. If you want to learn more about the VANOS system, go and watch my previous video where I discussed all the different VANOS symptoms. And if you like this video, please click the like button, subscribe to the channel, and stay tuned for more BMW content.